Welcome back to One Home Lab. Let's do some shady business. And by shady business, I mean using IoT shading with KNX. Implementing smart shading into your smart home projects has many benefits. The main three being energy saving, temperature management, and privacy. But now you might be asking, but why IoT shades? I can just use KNX shading in the projects and all is well in this world. Well, the reality is that to this day, a lot of KNX projects come furnished without internal or external shades. The reasons for that can be different. In some areas, it's just not so common. Maybe there are cooler areas and shading is not so required. Then in other instances, maybe these KNX projects already have IoT shades installed, for example, Somfy, and then the integrator needs a solution. And also one of the big reasons is that some customers simply don't go for KNX shading because of the price. If we consider the price of the motors, the actuators, the fabric, the mounting, and then we multiply this by many windows in a house, the price for KNX shading can go into the thousands. Here is where IoT solutions can really shine. They're much easier for retrofitting projects because of their ease of installation. Some of them are even battery powered or they require fewer cabling. They're also much cheaper and affordable. So it makes more sense for some customers to go for an IoT solution. Or if you're an KNX integrator, this can make it easier for you to upsell smart shading to your clients. This is exactly why we're making this video. We want to show you how you can implement matter-enabled smart shades into your KNX workflow, as straightforward as it gets, with the help of One Home Server KNX Pro or One Home IoT Gateway. Today we'll be checking out three IoT shading solutions from three different brands, and we'll show you how you can use products like this in conjunction with your KNX system. So for KNX devices, we have KNX pushbutton, we have a KNX actuator for our light, we have Jira X1 with the app setup, so we can show you how you can also control these blinds with any KNX enabled app. We have a Steinel, I'm sorry if I'm pronouncing this wrong, True Presence sensor, so we can automate something also based on presence, on light. And at the end, we got a nice little gift from our friends at Elsner. Thank you, Bastian. We have the Elsner Windancer GPS weather station. So with this, we can measure wind speed, we can measure brightness outside, we can measure temperature, and we can then automate our shading based on that. Of course, we went for a KNX weather station because currently there is no good IoT weather station that would be to our liking or enable everything that the KNX weather station does, especially on Matter. We're looking forward to that happening, but for now it still makes sense to go with a KNX weather station. Now that we've overviewed our setup, let's go into use cases. First of all, we have the IKEA Fyrtur. What are the pros? The price performance is outstanding. We got this particular model at 60 centimeter width for 79 euros at a discount. Of course, it's available in multiple widths, so it's really suitable for almost any project. The setup is really simple. You connect the device to Dirigera hub, calibrate it with IKEA Home app, and then connect it via Matter to One Home and of course to KNX. It has a nice minimalistic design. Due to the price performance, the design feels a little bit plasticky. We feel like maybe they're OEMing it from an outside manufacturer. And of course, a con is also you need an additional Dirigera hub, which needs to be purchased separately. But all in all, the shade has performed really reliably. The response time is near instant and we have been really happy. First, let's start simple. Let's control our IKEA smart blind with our MDT push button with the help of group addresses. Let me show you how this is done. For this, we'll be using the One Home IoT Gateway functionality, which enables you to map the actions of IoT devices to the group addresses that you have set up beforehand in ETS. This way, you keep the same workflow as you're used to as a KNX user, KNX integrator. You just add another layer functionality with IoT devices. So to control my IKEA blind with my MDT push button, I have set up the group addresses in ETS, so set up down, percentage status, and so on. And I have, of course, mapped it to my MDT push button, so function 5, function 6, or button 5, button 6. And then all I have to do, I go into One Home dashboard. Here I have already added my IKEA shade via Dirigir hub into One Home. And now I can go into integrations, KNX configure, and here bridge devices to KNX. And I have already pre-made this for the video, but if we check it out in the IKEA blind, you can see I have all my group addresses mapped to this IKEA blind. Now when I press the button to lower shades, the shades lower. Second of all, we have the Eve motion blinds. This is the brainchild of Eve and Coulisse, two companies that step together. They joined their smart home expertise and their blinds motors. They are presenting themselves as a bit of a more premium solution. So also the price is a bit more in the premium bracket. The motor kits start at 199 euros. And of course, the price also depends on what kind of fabric you choose, what's the width, and so on and so on. We got these particular motion blinds sent to us by motion blinds themselves. Of course, we're not paid to say anything about it. We just want to review it and show you how you can use it. They provided us with a nice demo stand, so we can also have it set up here in the office. And what I really like about their design is that they include a nice analog string control. Basically, you can also manually control this blind by pulling on the string. The blind goes down or up and then pulling again to stop the blind. It's really nice. The setup is quite simple. You do need a thread border router, so anything like an Apple HomePod or Apple TV of the appropriate generation will work. Then the device connects via the Eve app. You can calibrate it there and then bring it via Matter again to One Home and to KNX. One thing to mention is that we did have the chance to test this blind at Light and Building last year. And some of our employees did mention that the response time was a bit slow. We do have to tell you that that was a battery powered one, which goes to sleep, and then there's a wake up period before the blind starts to work. This model that we have here is a wired model, so the response time is a bit faster, though I must say it is noticeably slower than the IKEA blind. And here's the cool thing, because One Home enables you to control IoT devices with the help of group addresses, this also means you can control these devices with any KNX app. For my example, I'm using the Gira app. All I had to do is open up Gira Project Assistant, set up my blinds and map the group addresses I set up in the ETS beforehand, commission Gira X1, and now I can simply lower and raise the Eve motion blinds. It's really cool to see these IoT devices performing as they would be KNX devices. And last but not least, we have the Somfy TaHoma blind motors. Some of you might even consider this to be the only professional IoT shading solutions on the market. And we have to admit that, of course, Somfy has gained the reputation of being the Mercedes of blind motors even before they started introducing any smart home solutions. It is a very popular choice, especially with professionals, with integrators, and of course, it offers a lot of customizability. The thing is, though, you need a professional account to even be able to set up this device, which we got. We then connected it via Zigbee to a Dirigir hub, which is a Zigbee hub that then also opens devices up to Matter, so they can be brought to One Home. And we did have success in doing so, but the problem was that you cannot calibrate this Somfy motor in Dirigir. And then, of course, when it's brought to One Home, to KNX, there is no movement, even though the control is there. We have then figured out that we do need to first set this up in the TaHoma hub with the professional account, but so far we've had no success. Hey, Marcel from the future here. Just to let you know, we are in contact with the Somfy team and we are working on making this integration run smoothly. So once we get everything set up properly, we will be making a follow-up update and video to let you know how you too can set up these Somfy blinds to work with One Home and with KNX. So stay tuned for that update. Now let's get into some automations. At the start of the video, we mentioned that smart shading can really help with your privacy. Of course, when night falls, you're in the bedroom, you have the lights on, you of course don't want your shades to be fully opened for everyone to see you. So let's see how you can implement these IoT shades with KNX sensors to make these automations in One Home automations. Let's go to the automations tab in the One Home dashboard. And here I have prepared an auto privacy automation. We have a trigger that listens to value changes on our KNX light. So when the light is on in the room, the automation starts. Basically checks, the lighting is on. Okay, let's see what we do now. Then there's the conditions. If the time is 10 minutes before sunset, and there is also presence detected on our Steinel sensor, then we want to run an action, which is close all blinds. But we can do another thing. We can set another condition. We can check for brightness on our outside weather station. And if the brightness is low enough, maybe it's overcast, it's a bit evening, and there's also presence in the room, we will also run this automation, lower the shades, and keep our privacy intact. And while we're mentioning our KNX weather station with its wind speed sensor, we can also talk about an automation that can protect your external shades from breaking when the wind is really high. So here in One Home Automations, we have set our trigger, which listens for the Windancer wind speed sensor state changes. So it always tracks the speed of the wind that our KNX weather station records. Then we have a condition. If the wind speed exceeds 20 meters per second, of course, this is some strong wind building up. We could already decide to raise all blinds altogether, but we can also buffer this a bit with a delay. So we can say if the wind speed is 20 meters per second for more than 5 seconds, then we run the action of opening up our external blinds and protecting them from breaking. Now I really want to see if I can blow hard enough for this to spin fast enough to trigger the automation. Let's try. Ah. Another really useful automation you can create in One Home is temperature regulation with the help of IoT shades. If we look at the trigger here, we're listening for brightness and temperature changes on our Windancer GPS weather station. Of course, when the brightness value goes really up and also the temperature follows, this means that the sun is really shining hard, the temperature is rising. What should we do? Once we are sure that the brightness value and the temperature is above a certain level, we want to help our cooling system in our house to maybe not so work so hard by lowering our shades down. But of course, we don't want to just do this all over the place. You don't want your shades to constantly go up and down. Good automation is basically the ones you don't see, and that happens at the right time. How do we check that? Well, here we have a simplified version. Of course, you can go much more in depth, but for the conditions, we can first check if there is presence in the room where we want to close the shades. For example, that can be a room that is more on the sunny side. So we first check if present is detected. If it's not detected, we want to check whether the AC is running and what is the set point that this AC needs to reach. Of course, we also want to check what the current temperature is in our home and whether it is above a certain threshold or below. If all these conditions are true, then the automation can start. And for the actions, we actually used a scene that we configured in the newly released One Home scenes. But basically what this scene does is takes all the blinds in that room, groups them under one action, and that is all blinds down. It's automations like this that can really help manage the temperature in your home and also help conserve energy that is spent on cooling or heating. The same automation could also be used in reverse. So if we need more sunlight to heat the environment, of course, not to use so much HVAC system in our house. Maybe we open the blinds, we let some sun in. Once it warms up, we can lower the blinds down again. Okay, so that's it for this episode of One Home Lab. We must say that we are really impressed by these IoT shades that we have been testing. Gone are the days where these IoT devices are unreliable, unstable. We must say that in testing, all of these devices performed as advertised, were really stable, and are perfectly suitable for real-world use cases also in KNX. And the possibilities such devices open are really what's exciting for us. It enables integrators to offer more variety to customers. It enables easier retrofitting on projects that need such solutions. And also, as we mentioned, with One Home IoT Gateway, with One Home Server KNX Pro, you can use these devices as they would be KNX devices. The workflow doesn't change, just the possibilities do. That's all for now. If you want to learn more about how to integrate Matter devices into One Home, you can always check the video in the description down below.